everyone, this is Shebnam and as Radio Bilkent, we have a very special guest today. Luca from Italy's world famous club undertaking, the Cube Guys, is here with us. Welcome to our broadcast.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Thank you for coming here in my studio.
Yeah, it looks great. And I guess you are joining from Italy. How are things are there now in terms of the virus? And I hope you and your loved ones are okay.
Yeah, everything, you know, it's quite dramatic for some reasons, but as a musician, as a DJ, we have to keep going, you know, keep going, producing new music and new stuff, even if the situation in the country is not so positive, okay? But, you know, you have to keep the mood in a positive way to keep going, as I told you, no?
Mm-hmm. And you are actually keeping it up. You actually had many releases during this year.
Yeah, exactly. We never stop producing new music. We never stop recording new stuff here. And that's probably is one of our, you know, reasons to be creative, especially in these periods. We have a lot of ideas and consider that we're not traveling a lot all over the globe for gigs and other things.
You have time.
We have time right now to stay in the studio and to, you know, put on paper new ideas, new projects and new stuff. So that's the positive thing.
And that, what keeps you stay motivated and productive other than just having a lot of time?
Yeah, correct. It's all about your feelings and your spirit, your way of living. Because if you take care of too much at the news out there, you probably get, you know, get bored, or you don't want to go and be creative every day. But if mood is the right one, you can do it, and you can do it properly, as I told you, because you have a lot of time. And we have to take this, especially because one day this thing will be end. Okay, so we'll be back on the road and we'll be back on gigs. So that day we will have so much stuff and so much releases. We are lucky because we have our own label. So considering that these days the market is quite slow because no many DJs used to buy music, but at least we have our own label to release stuff, even in this day.
And you actually just released Everybody Knows It, a great collab with Orson Welles. How's it going?
Correct. And it's a funny guy. We met that guy so many years ago in Holland, okay? And we have a very good relation. So Orson proposed us this track for the label. We got good feeling from the first time we heard that, and we released it because we feel that sound could fit perfectly into what we usually play, what we usually spin, and on the label it's perfect. So it was just released 1 week ago. The track was good, and let's see.
Okay, great. And to forget about the virus for a while, I actually want to ask you some a bit different questions. And in the end, I also want to play a little word game with you, if you join me. Okay. Okay, so you celebrated your 15th year this summer.
Correct.
Yeah, and I wonder, what does it feel like to be in the industry for this long, or for this long as a duo, you know, like with someone all the time?
Probably one of the best reasons to keep going is to have a good relation, okay? So have a good relation, each other, have a good feeling for the music before everything, because, you know, the business is the business, but if you don't love exactly what you do, you probably get bored at some day, you know? But this thing is doing a very important part of the game. So have a good relation with each other and with the music, with the music production, and have fun. Even if sometimes the business and the work hours are very tough, you do it because you love it. So that's one of the reasons and one of the secrets probably.
Yeah, in every kind of relationship, probably, and in the band relationship as well.
Correct. Correct. So we have a lot of respect for each other. And we, as I told you, we feel that what we're doing is what exactly we get excited about.
Mm-hmm. Great. Congratulations for that, especially. And after like having a detailed look in your discography, I again realized that you remix some tracks from legendary rock bands, like Talking Heads or The Who. And which, let me say, Baba O'Reilly is one of my favorite songs. So I wanted to ask you, and I'm wondering about your influences in music. Like, who inspired you? Who do you listen to in general?
Honestly, we love globally music, and we don't have a specific genre to listen to when we are, for example, easy or far from the studio. We love to listen a little bit of everything, and that's why it's probably... We probably want to take influences from many kind of music, not only the club or dance music, you know.
Yeah.
This is one of the reasons to be creative every day in a different way and to get inspired by many things and many people and many producers and musicians out there. There's no particular style that we follow. We are house music, okay? Mm-hmm. But we like to put into this sort of concept anything that we really feel good for the dance floor and to get the people emotional about. So that's the reason why we took a little bit of elements from different music styles.
Yeah, I think it's a good approach to follow. And I'm gonna ask, like, if you're currently working on new projects or new Cube event, maybe.
Yeah, I can't wait to go back on clubbing side because we missed that. Specifically because the emotion that you have when you're playing in front of the people really helps you even here in the studio for the production side. You really have the back and forth relation about what you're playing at that moment and the reaction in front of you. So this is one of the things that are really missing right now. So the power, the contact with the crowd, and we're working on many projects with different kind of styles. As I told you before, we don't want to have strictly one channel only or one style. So housey, but a little bit of soulful, a little bit of techie, and we have a good news production to get out and release before the end of the year. But even in January and February, we are still planning the stuff for Cube Recordings, and let's see, because as I told you before, the market right now is quite slow. Mm-hmm. But I'm always very positive about it. Music before everything. Yes, that's the point.
Yeah, great. And actually, about that word game I mentioned, I was planning to ask you a few words, and I was just wanting you to tell me shortly what just pops into your head when you hear them, or how would you define them? And the first one was music, actually.
Yeah, music is everything. Okay, so it's my first love.
First love, great. Yeah. And when did you meet it?
Wow, you mean the music that I like, you mean, or general?
Yeah, when did you fall in love with it, if it's your first love? Just asking.
Yeah, it came from my daddy, first of everything, okay, when I was very, very young. And then I keep going, you know, listening and discovering artists, because when you are young, you are completely, how can I tell you, naked in terms of music experience. So you're ready to listen to a little bit of everything, and you can get inspired by people and a different kind of. So that's the point.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Second word, or two words, nightlife.
nightlife is fun and fashion, fun and crazy people, but good feelings.
Yeah, you actually describe yourself as crazy a lot. I've seen it in your channels, in your social media.
Madness. Yeah, don't stay too much serious. No, we have this kind of hashtag that we use sometimes that is never serious, always professional. Because it's our way of living. So take the things very professional, but not the feeling has to be not so serious. You have to be funny and you have to get inspired by the funny moments of our work, if you want.
Yeah, you give that energy in your posters, in your music, everywhere. I can say that I agree. And next word is radio, and we heard that you had your own radio show as well. Is that correct?
Yeah, radio is I mean, as radio, I put into even all the platforms that right now people used to listen to. Like Spotify or these things. So having a radio show gives us the opportunity to put our music out easily, okay? And I feel that our radio show really 100% reflects the music we play in the clubs. Because sometimes people used to play into the radio show some music that at the end they don't play live. But if you listen to our shows, we completely... 99.9% will play the same music live when you go gig.
And you can interact with people, actually, right?
Yeah, it's very important. You know, right now, even with social medias right now, the interaction with people gives me and Roberto the opportunity to real feel, have the feedback of what we're doing. Even if sometimes it's a quick video or a quick photo or a quick, you know, radio show or snippet of something, you can exactly feel what the people expect or not. And that's important. Now, the use of the social media right now in that way is very important for producers and musicians and people into this kind of entertainment business to have the right feeling and feedback immediately, no?
Yeah, and radio gives that opportunity 100%, I agree. And my next word is Roberto, and he's not here to be with us today.
Yeah, is here in the studio. If you want, Robbie. He's doing other business over there, but he's here. Here.
Hello.
Hi. Fine.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So, as you see, we're always split in the studio to do different kind of, especially when the studio is off of the volume, okay? So, but we're doing some office stuff, because sometimes we also do these things. You know, as I told you before, the relation is always very friendly.
Yeah, I understand, and I see it, and he doesn't speak English, I guess, but...
I speak, he completely understand everything about English, so you can do anything you want.
It's not good.
Yeah, maybe we can ask him your name and make him respond to it.
Yeah.
So, like, can you tell us a little bit about, like, when I say Luca to you, what comes into your head, and can you describe him?
About Roberto, you think?
No, I'm asking that through him, about you. How will he describe you?
Che ne pensi quando ti viene il mio nome in mente?
Fratello.
It's like the brothership. Yeah, yeah.
Great, great. You really get on well. Okay, and my next word was Halloween, and I wanted to ask you what scares you, because we are going to release that during our Halloween party that we are going to make.
Yeah, it's, you know, in Italy, Halloween was not so powerful as in the United States, for example. But having a baby of 7 years old right now, I feel Halloween much more than years before. So usually it's very good to play around in the clubs, because our feeling is that Halloween night has probably, right, in the last few years, has much more relevance than the New Year's Eve in terms of clubs, parties. Mm-hmm. So I had good memories about some years ago Halloween's party. Unfortunately, this year was everything was shut down. But as I told you, it's a very good party, good night party.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I hope we can just make parties again. You can be with the crowds again with your music. Yeah. And we hope to see you in Turkey too.
Yeah, I can't wait to be back over there, because I always love that culture.
Really? So
I know that there is a very good culture about us music also. So I can't wait to be back.
Yeah, and thank you again both for this interview and for the brilliant set you sent us. Obviously, we can't just wait to share it online with our listeners at RadioBilkent.com and at the frequency 96.6 all around Turkey. And we are thanking a lot to Ingenium Records and Carlos. And Berk İnal is also saying hi to you. He was the one connected you from our radio. Yeah, my questions are done today.
Opportunity, and I really hope to see you guys very soon over there. Let's stay positive and let's keep going.
Yeah, keep going is the message of this interview.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.